that? Priscilla, is she gonna live?
I'd say that's certain. Her condition's critical but stable.
Oh,
my beg your pardon, but you are a relative?
Relative? No, a friend. A very close friend.
Dandelion, correct? She uttered the name in her few moments of lucidity. I am Joachim von Gratz, head of surgery. Until recently, a lecturer at Ochsenfurt Academy.
Enough of the courtesies. What are her injuries, besides her eye?
A concussion, cranial swelling, incision into her larynx, and scalding inside the throat and esophagus. Clearly someone forced her to imbibe a caustic fluid.
Okay.
So this was no ordinary attack, no robbery.
Clearly not. It was the act of a demented mind, and not its first.
How can you know that?
I've seen wounds like this. They're not the kind one would forget, don't you agree? In fact, just this week, a corpse turned up in the morgue with similar injuries. And no heart.
No heart? You mean that might have happened to Priscilla? Is someone looking into this?
This is Novigrad. Only the innocent burn here.
Geralt, I know I owe you 100 times over, but I need to ask you another favor. Find the bastard who did this. Find him. And kill him.
Don't need any convincing. Come on, Dandelion. Let's think about what we can do.
I would suggest examining the previous victim's corpse. It has yet to be autopsied. Doing so could very well provide some clues. No need to look astonished, gentlemen. As a surgeon, I know the importance of preventive medicine. Rather than wait for this maniac to strike again, I'd prefer to excise him. Not unlike a tumor.
All right.
Think they'll let me into the morgue?
By the main entrance, certainly not. But you can also get inside through the sewers.
The sewers? Travel them often, Doctor?
As often as required for, the pursuit of preventive medicine.
Alternative treatments. Aggressive ones, I'm guessing. Interesting.
We can discuss this en route. Are you ready?
Yeah. Let's go.
Mm-hmm. Ready and intrigued. I'll get whoever did this, Dandelion. Even if it's Hierarch Himmelfarb himself.
Thanks.
You lead.
So, preventive medicine you practice in the sewers. What's that about?
Think. Sewing up drowner victims can grow awfully tedious. Is it not better to nip the problem in the bud? I tried to get the temple guard to enter the sewers. Hear that?
Been hearing it for a while. Draw your weapon.
At least he's got one. Maybe I should first see about... Let me check my skills real quick. Okay, so still not. I have 3 points. I really should spend them, but I'm still having a hard time deciding what I want to spend them on. So we'll wait for that. We heard some guys, right? What are you doing? Are you reloading? Or loading for the first time? Okay, there's someone around here. Oh, I see him. Sneak attack! Not very sneaky. Okay. Oh, can we not? Can we not spam the same move over and over again? That would be fucking great. Fucking burn him. Did he fight back? There we go. Gotta save a friend. Okay. Well, that went well. I think you shot them, what, once? Don't worry, I didn't do so hot either. That way, we'll switch back. Oh, I see you. I see you, water hag. Oh, yeah, that's right. Ooh, I saw that. What you gonna do? I forgot she throws shit. Let's go. Oh, burn! I hate that shit. Ooh. No, don't you dare throw shit at me. Apparently, this water hag is a lot tougher. Didn't realize. Level 17. Alright. I'd like to loot this water hag. There. They always have good stuff, though. Okay, I need to actually drink. I'm doing really shitty. Why do I not... That's weird. I do not have my... I gotta do it from here. There we go. We're both gonna shoot. Yay, teamwork. You're a horrible shot. My turn. Yeah, that's how you do it, punk. Are we gonna have a competition? I got that person. Your turn. You take a shot first, okay? Ready? Go ahead, shoot. You missed. Come on, shoot a little lower. I'll just go kill him real quick. Let's go, punks. That's not what I want. At least it protected me. Come on. You son of a... Now would be the great time to shoot this one. Do you mind? Can you shoot one? He is a horrible shot. There we go.
Lost it. I kill one, another takes its place.
You kill none. That's how it works.
Believe me.
Kill one my ass.
Where to now? Up?
Yes, it's not far now.
Priscilla, how's it look? Give it to me straight, no sugarcoating.
Her wounds will heal, but it's her voice that concerns me. Mm. Surely you understand what a terrible blow that would be to a Trobriet. Enough to strip her of the will to live.
Any remedy for that?
I fear only your friend Dandelion can be of help on that count.
Yeah, that's true, you know. It's more of a personal, like, I can't live with this kind of
thing. Take the ladder.
How am I supposed to take it if it's attached? I'll just climb it instead, sir.
Alright. This is the place. Come. The quicker we take care of this, the better.
Why? Okay. Got somewhere to be?
Someone might disturb us. The coroner, for example. Or Reverend Nathaniel Pastori. Very well. We seek the corpse of a dwarven woodcarver.
Okay. The corpse of a dwarven woodcarver. Okay. This guy?
Looks like necrophage has got to this one. Let's keep looking.
Okay. This one?
Human. Wrong body type.
All right. Let's keep checking then. A lot of rooms in here. Okay, there's a bunch of bodies over here.
That's gotta be him.
Oh, sweet!
This one's a
third time's a charm.
Remember, beards are no indicator of gender amongst dwarves.
So that's a no. Okay. Why is my mission still stay freaking Skellig? Stupid thing. There. Probably tell me straight up where it's at.
A dwarf, but the hands. Not a carpenter's. A banker's, more likely. Calluses on the fingers, sawdust in the beard, clothes sticky with sap. Must be our dwarf.
Excellent. I trust you don't grow weak in the knees at the sight of blood?
Not a bit. Start the autopsy.
Where?
Probably torso, right? Don't you normally... I don't even remember what we're really looking for. Let's go there.
Let's examine his torso.
What have we here?
Chest?
Deep wound on the left side of his rib cage, and a scar the length of his stomach.
Yeah, check it.
Let's examine the chest wound. Yeah, heart carved out, wound cauterized.
Wait a minute, there's something else.
Oh. Oh.
An egg from an amphibian. A salamander? Scorched but intact.
I attended some lectures in herpetology as a student. Afraid I don't recall any amphibians that would lay eggs in corpses. So either Professor Cochrane was deeply mistaken, or this is our murderer's doing.
But why would you... Okay, keep checking.
Look at the scar. Wounds long and thin, an incision, but the edges are ragged.
Means nothing. Look, no swelling, no bruises. An old injury, perhaps an accident in the workplace.
Fair enough. I guess open them up. That's what I thought we were doing in the first place.
Open the abdominal cavity.
Due warning, it will stink of rot.
Once fought a Zoogle up to my waist in sewage, so I doubt... Wait. Smells not rot.
Formaldehyde. A medical novelty. Heavily diluted, it's remarkable at preserving organic tissue. In stronger proportions, it's more destructive than acid.
Explains why there's no smell of decay, and why his throat scalded.
Well, this is getting interesting. I see his eyes seem to be taken out, so let's observe his head.
Let's look at his head. Hair smells like it's burnt. Like he was in a fire.
Notice anything else? That his eyes have been scooped out, for instance?
Yeah, eye sockets would be nice.
Those burn marks I see in his eye sockets.
Yes, and some gray dust. Ash, it seems. Very fine.
Murderer gouged out his eyes, then put burning coals in the sockets.
So it seems. Looking at the wounds, it appears our woodcarver was still alive when it happened.
Oh, damn. What a poor guy. That is... That's some horrible stuff right there.
Let's examine the mouth. Burns. Blisters.
Just like Priscilla's.
See this? Incision made into the voice box.
Indeed. So thin as to be nearly unnoticeable.
A small, extremely sharp instrument. Scalpel?
But why? The wound is too small to bleed, and there are signs of swelling. The murderer... I believe he performed a tracheotomy, so the victim wouldn't die too soon.
That's some messed up shit. The tracheotomy... I always bought the last part. That itself is like crazy shit, where you just cut open the throat basically so they can breathe. But to do it so they suffer more, this is getting crazy. Let's just go down the rest of the list, I guess.
Look at his hands. These welts. Rope burns, right? He was tied up.
I'd expect so. No one could sit through such torture unless bound.
Speaking from experience...
Yes, that of a victim. Spent a year in the dungeons of Tretagor. Long story.
Some other time, maybe. See the callus? Our dwarf wore a ring, but someone took it off him. See anything interesting on his legs?
His right foot. The ankle swollen, toenails broken. He clearly kicked something very hard. Right before he kicked the bucket.
Doesn't strike me as the right time for jokes.
Apologies. We surgeons, we've a different sensibility.
Mm-hmm. And a different sense of humor.
I thought it was kind of funny. And the genitals, if they're even still there.
His genitals. We ought to inspect those.
I sincerely doubt they bear any relation to the matter.
We'll see.
We'll see. Pull down his trousers and... shit.
Syphilis, actually. Early stages. No sign of diffusion.
Think there could be a connection?
Only as the killer's potential motivation.
Fair enough. Alright. That's it. Overall, he's gone through some shit.
All right, think I know enough.
Enlighten me, please, because I've still no notion what this is about. What the motive might have been.
Well, it could be a ritual murder, it could be punishment. I mean, it could be murder's mad, but not like this. Not that kind of torture, not the coals in the eye sockets. But I want to say punishment, like maybe he just hated him, but if he's doing it to these people, don't have anything in relation, Priscilla and the dwarf. So I kind of want to say it must be a ritual murder. The, you know, salamander egg and the coals. It's just, I don't know if it is, but out of these options, I feel like maybe.
It's some kind of sick ritual. You saw it. Burns in the eye sockets, cavity where the heart should be, scalding liquid, all centering on warmth, heat, fire.
A fire eternal.
It's a lead worth following. Any idea what his name was?
Fabian Meyer. And I'm Hubert Reich, the coroner. I've come to perform the autopsy, but I see you've done it for me, Joachim. As always, you interfere where you're neither needed nor wanted, drag others into trouble in the process. Who is this?
A student. Lifelong learner. Got a couple questions for you.
Very well, speak. But be quick. Reverend Nathaniel has come by for an inspection. He'll be here shortly.
Alright, you know what? If we gotta work quick, I'm assuming they do know each other. Not important.
Wood Carver's body. Where was it found? It's important.
Plan to investigate? Exciting. He died in his workshop south of the Market Square, just beside the gate to Far Corners. That poor Trebirance was attacked there. City's abuzz about it. But the wood carver, Eustace, the corpse collector, brought us the body. You should speak to him. Saw him just around the corner near... Oh, greetings, your reverence.
That was quick.
Who are these people? I believe I made it clear no one's to be allowed in under any circumstances.
You did, but they're friends of the deceased. Here to collect the body.
Out of the question. Show them out at once.
As your reverence wishes. Gentlemen, follow me. You shall leave via another route.
Why do you cover for us?
I was covering my own arse. If Reverend Nathaniel had learned someone had entered the morgue, then cut open a corpse without his permission, I'd be in deep trouble. But you didn't give that a thought, did you, Joachim? As ever. Well, while I don't approve of your willfulness, I also wish to see this murderer hang. So, should I learn anything new related to this case, I will let you know.
Thank you.
Alright. Yeah, Nathaniel looked like the guy from the flashback. Some people look alike, but it could be him. Therefore, he's the one who had, you know, Siri and Dandelion arrested, although Siri teleported out. But, yeah, let's see if we can get to know more about him.
Nathaniel, who is he?
A scoundrel. A rogue. Like every man who wears the robes of the Eternal Fire.
Most are scoundrels before they ever put on the robes.
True in his case as well. Before he donned the frock, Nathaniel was a torturer. Delighted especially in torturing women. Later, Hierarch Hemelfart appointed him to oversee the morgue. He deals with the temple guard, supervises cremations, conducts funeral masses in the temple on the Isle, and so forth.
Dream job.
Alright.
Might have told me you know the coroner. We could have skipped the trip through the sewers.
I know him, thus I avoid him. I've said enough on the subject.
You know what? I don't care, to be honest. I won't press you.
Don't aim to press you.
Thank you. I've nothing to hide. It's just an old wound, unhealed as yet. What will you do now?
Plenty of leads. Woodcarver's workshop, the corpse collector who found him, alley where Priscilla was attacked. Got work to do.
As do I. At the hospital. I must return there. But I shall keep my fingers crossed.
And I'll keep my eye on you.
I like how the guard's just listening on a conversation right there. Hey guard, you didn't hear anything.
Another drifter in from Temeria.
Alright, well the corpse collector is close. So we might as well check on him first. He's right over here.
Bloody bandits! Can't go out in the streets.
Hey Eustace, I see you're keeping busy.
You Eustace, the corpse collector?
I? How'd you know?
Fourth sense, I think it is. You bring Fabian Meyer's body to the morgue?
Fabian? Oh, yeah, I remember. No ice, no art, one of them, right? No purse neither, as I recall.
One of them? So there have been other bodies like that?
Sure have. Beggars, street urchins, and street walkers. One went so poorly, I had to cut her into pieces to fit her in me wheelbarrow. Slippery Sow, they called her, on account of her.
Some things are best left unsaid. What happened to the pieces?
What do you mean? Reverend Nathaniel ordered them burned. Every last one. Oh, shame that was.
Shame? Why? Actually, never mind. Another thing that's best left unsaid.
All right, well, yeah. Search.
You search Fabian's body?
Well, I cast an eye in his pockets. Made sure nothing went to waste.
I call a spade a spade. You rob corpses.
And I call a prick. It's none of your fucking concern. What, you tax collector? Piss off, mutant.
I'm really pushing to getting that delusion. I got 3 points. I can get delusion level 3, damn it. Maybe I will do it, just to have it.
I'd advise you not to anger me, or you'll get an inside tour of the crematory.
Touch me, the guards will be hiding your ass for you count of 3.
To save a little shit like you? Doubt it.
He's clever, lads. More clever than you. They know Eustace. Know they want me on their side. Cause you'll all die one day, and then I'll decide where your body winds up. A grave, the crematorium, or elsewhere.
You know what? You know what? Screw it. I'm not paying this little shit. I'm gonna do my delusion.
We'll meet again.
Aye. When I load you into me wheelbarrow.
You little shit. I'm gonna do it right now. I'm gonna do it right now. I don't even care. He's pressured me. I want. Yep. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna do it. Blah blah blah. This is it, right? Axie in dialogue situations. Boom. And then dialogues. Got level 2. I gotta put this down here. Should I push it straight to level 3 now? Nah. When we come to a level 3 one, then we'll do it. Right now, they're all level 2s. Get back here, you little shit.
What? You ought to thinking? Won't tell you nothing, freak.
That's what you think, punk.
Talk. What did you find on him?
I had you wish. Triflings, baubles, gloss beaded ring, handful of coins, and a letter. Look, vellum, quality parchment that. I'll wipe off the writing of Solitor's knee.
That's human skin. Priscilla, next victim's name. If you'd given this to the right person, she might not have been hurt.
What the fuck do I care what happens to some Priscilla? We short of wenches in this town.
I should hit him, but... It's just...
Get
we're
out
good
of my
friends.
Sight. Now.
Not cause any more trouble than we already have so far. Examine the place where the woodcarver died. Alright. She's been crying that whole conversation. Alright, let's get over there. We got a mystery to solve.
Interesting.
Alright, is it in here? Can we go in through here?
Anyone home?
Begone! and I'll set me hounds on you. Molly, Strigger, come!
Relax. I'm here about Fabian Meyer, looking for his killer.
That's altogether different. Sit, you stupid mutts, lie down!
What?
Come on in. Slowly now, lest they bite you.
They'd only get to bite me once. Nah. They're just doing their job. They're good dogs.
So who might you be?
The Stiff's brother. Gus is the name. We ran a workshop together. Meyer and Meyer.
Meyer Squared. That is a big
What'll it be now? Just Meyer?
Name it. I'll be closing it down now. As soon as I find a buyer for this shack, I'll head on to Mahakam. Be near to my family or what's left of it. So, what do you want to know? What can I tell you about Fabian?
Yeah, how much do you know?
Tell me what you know about the murder, in order, in detail.
It was like this. Had some work in Oxenfurt, and I was coming home. Saw a plume of smoke rising over the city. Thought to myself, blast it, gonna miss and burn another hag. But the smoke wasn't coming from Hyrax Square. It was coming from here. See the soot stains? That's where they burned our sculptures. Folk gathered around the blaze, and found Fabian here beside it. They'd already loaded him on the cart by the time I arrived.
Talk to your neighbors. They see anything suspicious beforehand? Hear anything?
Claimed not to. But even if they had, they'd not have helped. In Novigrad, folk give bleeding orphans in the street a wide berth so as not to stain their poor lanes. What do they care about some dwarf?
I hear you.
Your brother have any enemies? Anyone dislike him? Threaten him, maybe?
T'was Fabian who threatened this one lass. Oh, you were a good dwarf, a craftsman like no other. But you were an incorrigible whoremonger as well. Whenever we put a bit of coin aside, I'd say, let's buy some tools, quality timber. No, he grabbed the purse and head out whoring. Took to following one in particular. He'd say, "'Tis all your fault, dirty bitch, human dish rag, and other obscenities. Don't rightly know what that was about. Maybe he was in love with her.
Know where I can find her, this dish rag?
City cemetery. She died a few days back, quietly in her sleep. Her pawn said a fever took her.
Okay, let me look around.
Fine, we've talked enough. Need to look around.
Be my guest. Just beware of the dogs.
Look at him. Oh, hot damn.
Bloodstains.
That's where Fabian lay when they found him.
Okay.
Statues of the old gods. Nothing but women. Shapely ones.
Okay, what is this? Drag marks?
Someone dragged something across the floor. Or dragged it from one wall to the other, repeatedly.
Can I go in here? Oh, there's a book over here. Oh, or a sermon. Should probably read it. Let's, see what that's all about. Alright. Remember, good people, that fire can be both a blessing and a curse. Fire can warm with its flames. Fire can prepare our nourishment. Fire can drive off the horrors of the dark. Yet fire can also scorch, burn, and incinerate. That is why we must live in harmony with eternal fire and its commandments. Whoever fails to heed its lessons, whoever lives in ignorance of it, whoever mocks it, the same shall lose his life in its flames. Take my counsel to heart, good people, or you will reap the consequences of your deeds. A concerned citizen. Alright, interesting. Let's see, where else can we go inside this building? Do you mind if I go inside?
Mind if I go inside the workshop?
I've not even peeked inside since they found Fabian. But I'll open it for you if you want.
You never know. They obviously drug something around. Thanks, man. Oh. Oh, okay. Just roll. Do your thing. What we got?
More blood stains, but not near enough to say he bled to death.
Okay, let's check this first.
Unless somebody got rid of the blood, left a few stains behind. Furniture got knocked over. This looks like it was kicked. Formaldehyde. Doubt Fabian used it.
Can I follow the scent? I don't want to loot. What else we got? I saw something over here. Come on. Come on. Oh, I saw that. There we go. Up. Oh, damn it. Up.
Oh. Eyes. Humanoid. Completely rotten. Nothing here.
Huh. Okay, well, I can't seem to find anything else. So, thanks, man. Now let's go see if we find any similar things where Priscilla was attacked. Good dog. All right, let's go. Oh, there we go. All right, let's go. Let's go check it out over there.
Got my eye on you, one.
Dang it! Come on. I can never get this right.
Oi, Witcher! Coroner wants to see you. Been another victim. Told me to say the main door will be open for you. You're to come as soon as you can.
Alright. Sounds good. As soon as I check this place out.
What do you want?
Hey, handsome.
Hey. You see any dead people recently? No? You don't want to have anything to do? I didn't think so. Okay. What we got?
A brazier.
Say
this time of year?
Dame.
How am I to know? Watch him, see what he does.
What? Really?
Take him back.
Okay, apparently I can do this hand to hand style. Okay, I see how it is. I tell you, Okay. Okay, let's see how this is. Get out of here. I want to take this guy out first. Let's go. No, I want to take this guy out first, mother truckers. Okay, fine. Take him out. Oh, take him out. Ooh, take him out. Oh, what? So close.
Eye for an eye! Slaughter the freak!
Okay, that's it. Knock this guy out! Thank you! Oh my gosh! How you like one-on-one, punk? I didn't think so. Not so tough now, huh? Not so tough! Didn't think so!
Think you'll gut me too, huh? Up your ass, deviant! Hoes can fight back!
Calm down, I'm not gonna hurt you. What are you doing here?
Getting vengeance. Well, why are you staring? Have you not heard killers always return to the scene of their crime? Me and my brothers are waiting here to give him a warm welcome for Priscilla. Almost did her in, the whole son.
I know. Here to look for clues and find anyone who might know something.
Fear I can't help you much, but I can tell you what I know.
Oh.
Alright. Alright.
Priscilla wasn't the sole victim. You aware of that?
Oh, dearie. Of course I was. This didn't start yesterday. Others have died like this before. Beggars, street girls, orphans. But who'd have a drama concern about them? Human rubbish. It's what the guards call us.
Recall any names?
They didn't have proper ones. Baldy, curly, buns. That's what folk called them. No friends, no families. Their bodies were burned long ago.
You and Priscilla friends?
Friends? Nah. But she saw more than a stupid whore in me. Treated me with respect. It mattered. I was looking to give up whoring. Pick up a decent trade. But none would take me. Not as a washerwoman, nor a servant, nor a cook. Felt like a leper, I did. But Priscilla, she was different. Agreed to put me in her play, you see? Lots of the other actors, they were afraid on account of her jesting about the eternal fire. Whistling Wendy on stage, can you imagine it? Well, dream's gone now. I'm back to working street corners.
Sorry to hear that.
You could do worse as work goes. Or so I tell myself.
Take care now. I gotta look around some more. Appreciate it if you didn't disturb me.
Naturally. We'll stand aside, behave. But do tell us if you find anything else here.
Oh, the head's ringing.
I knew it was gonna be a problem. Okay. I don't even remember what this was.
A brazier. This time of year?
Okay. Come on, the scent.
I know that smell. Formaldehyde.
Okay.
Man's footprint. The murderer's maybe. Weighed on his heel. Took a step back. Human. Priscilla's. Murderer fled before the guards arrived. Ran this way.
Okay. Can I check the footsteps again?
Trail ends here. Strange. Even I couldn't jump this wall.
Okay, so they went there to put this on there, which is probably going to be the same... Yeah, it's the same one. Yep. It's the same sermon. Alright. Well, they're placing these everywhere. Should I tell her? Nah. Wait, I'll tell her once I solve it. Alright. Open. Thank you. Alright, back to the corner. Let's go. We got more bodies to cut up, look at. Although it could just be a trap because Nathaniel's probably in on it. That's a possibility.
Double shots.
Yeah, that might be. What we got? Same stuff?
Geralt, right? I'm glad you're here. Held off on the autopsy till you arrived.
Nice of you, especially given you didn't seem pleased about my previous visit.
Because you came unannounced and in unfortunate company. I also had Reverend Nathaniel to contend with. Our spiritual caretaker has left the city on some important matter. And I know who you are, what drives you. I'm more than happy to aid your investigation.
Alright, seems like a nice guy.
Not fond of Nathaniel?
Very few people are. He's cruel and capricious. He stormed in here once, grabbed a scalpel I was sterilizing over a burner, sliced my back with it to the bone, because I had forgotten to lock the storeroom. Hard to be fond of someone like that, wouldn't you agree?
I would have just killed him.
By the way, you and Von Gratz don't exactly get along. Why is that?
I had him sent to prison. You see, Joachim led the student protests in 1242, a senseless and brutal revolt. People were dying, Witcher. Those who rejected liberty, equality, and fraternity would be found in the gutter come morning. Their throats slit from ear to ear with surgical precision. Joachim had been my favorite student, but alas, I had to do something. So I reported him. Then I left the university and found work in the morgue, where none care about my past. Whereas Joachim, oh, fate's ironies. Years later, he was appointed head of the very ward I had founded.
All right.
Choosing the lesser evil can be hard at times. Happen to know a thing or two about that.
In that respect, this work has its benefits. I couldn't possibly hurt anyone here if I tried.
Alright. Well, who's the victim?
Who's the victim this time?
Joris Aquinas, a lecturer in theology at Oxenfurt Academy. Found this morning at his home on a catafalque made of his books.
Any titles in particular?
It seems all the tomes dealt with the eternal fire. Treatise critical of the faith's doctrines.
Yeah, mortal sin in Novigrad. Let's start.
Gladly. The wounds conform to the killer's modus operandi. The victim was bound and forced to drink formaldehyde. Next, the killer removed the eyes, placed burning coals in the sockets, then opened the rib cage and... What's this? A parchment. Made of human skin.
A message from the murderer. The name of his next victim. Patricia Vagelbud.
Gods, he knows no bounds. To attack Lady Vagelbud, heiress of such a prominent family.
Where is she? Tell me.
She resides in an estate beyond the city, north of Oxenford.
Gotta find her, now.
Okay, we gotta work quick. Let's all go to Vagelbud. Wait, Vagelbud, talk with Vagelbud before? Race. Oh, that sounds important. Didn't we talk to Vagelbud before? Wasn't she one of the people we had to talk to when working with Dandelion? Or we happened to talk to? I don't know. But whoever she is, we need to save her, and she's very far away. So, let's book it. Okay, here we are. This is the Vagelbud. Okay, this is the fancy. The horse races are over there, but this time we're actually going straight up. We gotta warn him. Hey, yeah, I know. You're not gonna like me going in, but I... Here, okay, we'll talk to the guards.
What are your wounds?
Yeah.
Need to talk to Patricia Vagelbud.
You think any bum off the street can...
I could
her
kill you in a second.
Her life's in danger. Let me in or have her blood on your hands.
If you thought this up, and I'll let you in, I'll throw my arse out the door.
Always thought a guard was supposed to protect his charge, not his ass.
So be it. I'll take you to Lady Vagelbud. Just no trickery. Understand?
Yeah, feels you.
Yes, good fellow? If it's work you seek.
Don't know that I'm all that good. Name's Geralt. Looking for Patricia Vagelbud. Her life's in danger.
In danger? Come now. I saw Mother this morning. She seemed sad, true, but in perfect health.
Yeah.
I'm hunting a serial killer, and I've got reason to believe your mother will be his next victim.
Why, even if it's true, our gods.
He's exceptionally cruel when he kills, tortures his victims, cuts out their hearts. So let's see how she is, just in case.
I find this all very hard to believe, but you appear to be quite serious. Please, follow me.
Man, if you saw a gray-haired, scarred-eyed, two-sword-wielding guy...
Except it's the wrong time of year.
I mentioned Mother seemed sad.
What?
Do you remember? In fact, she's in the midst of a crisis of faith. A rather serious one.
Well, no wonder she's a target.
Mother had seen the pyres in Hierarch Square, uttered not a word on our way home. She had all the holy books, insignias, reliquaries gathered, taken outside and burnt. Then she locked herself in her room.
How do you...
We need to hurry.
How do you say she's healthy if all that happened? Are you stupid? Just quit. Start running.
Ow!
None of that sounds healthy.
Calm and quiet. All seems to be in order.
I heard a scream.
We should go in, just to be sure.
You're relentless, aren't you? Fine. But wait here, please. Mother's certainly not in the mood for guests.
See? Told you. Okay, race to this. Go. I gotta be in a hurry. Nope, we're in a hurry.
Spread out! Murderer's still here!
Please don't think I'm the murderer. I really don't want to have to kill people. I don't want to-
oh, there he is! Get him!
Oh, fuck. I don't want to have to... chase the murderer. What? I'm not... I don't want to have to fight them. They didn't do anything wrong. Fuck.
Die, mutants!
Ah, these guys didn't do anything wrong. I don't want to have to kill them. Some of this shit. I should have came healed. Oh, fuck. Nope, wrong button. That's what I meant to click. That's a big difference of a button. Nope, thank you. Never picks the target I want. Dodge that. Come on, come on. Oh shit, I did not see that guy running.
Die, mutants!
Fucking A.
Halt! Or I'll put a bolt between your eyes!
Listen, you got the wrong guy.
Save your trickery, taking you to the heiress.
Well, killer's already escaped. Lead the way, hero.
Dang it.
We got him, Lady Ingrid. Wasn't easy, but...
Lower that crossbow before you hurt yourself. This man is innocent.
Way to go, dumbass.
I saw him running. Thought it was the killer fleeing.
I was chasing him, and I'd have caught him if you hadn't gotten in my way.
Out of my sight, at once. Mother... Why did he do this to her? Why?
Yep.
Because she blasphemed the Eternal Fire. Only thing that ties her to the other victims. Ingrid, I know this is a hard time for you, but... Usually the killer leaves a note on the body. A note indicating his next victim. May I?
Very well. But you should be on your own. I do not wish to see her in this state. I do not wish to remember her like that.
I don't blame you.
And let her be the last victim. Please.
I'm doing my best, Ingrid.
Bruises, broken fingernails. She defended herself. Must be why it took him longer. And why he almost got caught. Here it is. Sweet Nettie, Crippled Cates. Growing bolder, not just the name, but the place too. Won't get away this time.
Why? This one's tied up though.
Same wounds as the previous victims. Examination would be a waste of time. Gotta get to Crippled Cates, fast.
What about the loot? Oh, no, come on. Come on, there we go. Oh, it's the sermon, and then this is obviously the sense.
Another empty formaldehyde bottle.
Okay. Just want to double check. You never know when you find a little something extra. Alright. Once again, we have to run far away to... figure this out. Ah, it's probably not the smartest idea in the fire. Okay. Alright, girl. This is gonna be it. No more death. We gotta capture whoever this murderer might be. Okay. Let's get on over there. Alright, we're almost there. I healed up and got some swallow. Just in case things get a little dicey. Alright, I'm guessing this is the entrance.
Sweet Nettie, where is she?
Upstairs. But she's with a very important client. Do not disturb them.
Oh, yeah, totally. Won't disturb them. See ya. This is definitely an important client. Hi, how y'all doing? Excuse me.
Black ones,
pardon me.
Long as they pay.
I need to go up higher. Okay, where's the frickin'... Oh, there they are. Sorry. Okay. Is it right here somewhere? Come on.
No one will hear you, bitch. Not a soul.
You, though? Whole town will hear you in a minute.
Yet again you disturbed me. And I so dislike being disturbed. I was to play with sweet Nettie, render her not so sweet, but I shall see to you first.
You know what? I don't care why.
Try it, you bastard.
go, punk. Although I'm swinging like everybody. Oh, let's go. Oh, shit. That's some, got some range on that thing. Woo! Safety first. Heavy. That's right, punk. That's the way to finish him. He was getting ahead of himself. I could be a coroner pun guy. Oh, a poker. Thanks. Now you need some saving.
You're free now.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. If not for you. He asked if I did everything and I said, for the right price, of course. And then he smiled. Oh God, it came with the shivers. And then he hit me so hard I passed out. I was bound when I came to. And he was here in the poker, in the fire.
Calm down. He won't hurt you anymore. He won't hurt anyone.
The moment I saw that guy, I knew he needed to die. At least it's all over with now. Alright. Let's talk to Dandelion, I guess, and hopefully Priscilla heals up soon. I'm surprised that he didn't manage to get to her to be... Like, he didn't kill her. Someone must have saw and stopped it or something.
He made me to grab another lass to join us.
Is that not the way out? No, oh, this way. Alright, well... Let's head on back to Dandelion and... tell him the deed's been done. Everyone can rest easy. Oh, this is the hospital. I got here and I'm like, why is it... This doesn't look like the place. I know it's been renovated, but what the heck? Alright, we're at the hospital. Which makes complete sense. Oh, that's kind of creepy, actually, not gonna lie. I'm just gonna walk on up, thank you very much.
They say.
Hey. In here. How's it going?
How's
better, right?
Yes.
Okay. She can talk, she's awake, it's all good.
Did you take care of what I asked?
Yes, I did.
Yeah. The Witcher's way.
Thank you, Geralt. For me and Priscilla.
Yeah, no need.
Don't mention it. Nothing a friend wouldn't do. She's talking again. Nice surprise.
Isn't it? Professor Von Gratz told me her wounds are healing faster than a troll's. Not the most flattering comparison, but encouraging. Maybe she might even sing again someday.
Maybe.
For now, we'll try performing as a duo. She'll play the lute, I'll sing. Dandelion and Calinetta. Got a nice ring to it, doesn't it?
Sounds great. Good luck, Dandelion. On stage and off.
Good luck, man. Hopefully all goes well and you keep up with your new renovated, whatever you got, I can't remember. Card day or something. Oh, this place is depressing. Okay, we gotta get out of here. Alright.
Fucking hayos.
Wow, everybody. Well, that's that. At least she's, recovering. So, that's good to know. As for what's next, we still got a lot of stuff in town, so I say why not get it over with before we go to Skellig. So, we got a bunch of different stuff we could go. Fists of Fury. How about something, nothing's easy, but something easy. Attack the Witch Hunters in front of Pilipe's hut. Let's meet with Triss. It's been a while since we've seen her, so why not? And it's not that far away.
Hey, pretty boy. What do I
Yes, that is a pretty dog. Okay, let's go talk to Triss. This way. Stupid mini-map.
Oh.